It's a close coming. Okay. Hey, Evan. Where's the other friends? Okay. Good. Okay, good. So I have to tell you get your cancel. Let me get. Yeah, Friday. Is Alice going coming with you? She not here in the classroom? She's here? Okay, so we'll start first, okay? So write your name, we done the test already, so we start a new lesson, okay? Hi, so I think if she saw you coming, or not. Oh, she's there, she's right there. Okay, get your pencil, write your name, please.
And, all right, part 4.
Is today the second?
Yes.
Okay, so I saw some of you on GG, you moved to division, right? But we still on...
I already passed.
You passed division, awesome, but that's GG. But in your class, you're still on multiplication, right?
No.
Where, what chapter are you in now? Okay, so we are in there. Okay, so let's start with this lesson in route to estimate the products. Okay, write your name and today's date. Okay, so remember we are working on time, multiples of 10, right? Multiple of 100 and multiple of 1,000. We did it last time, right? So today we look at this one, we say 4 times 63. 63 is not an even number, so we kind of hard. So now, in order to find the products, to estimate a product, round the greater factor to a simpler number. So we make this number simple. Everyone eyes up here, please. So 63. So look at the number line. This is 60. Okay, 60. So do you think 63 right here is close to 60 or close to 70? Is 63 close to 60 or close to 70?
60.
Close to 60. So we round it up. We round it down. So 4 instead of we do 4 times 63, we will do 4 times 60, right? So this more easier because look up here. So when you do multiple of 10, you cover 10. So 6 times 4 is what? 6 times 4 is?
24.
So you write 24 and you add 10 because that's a 10, correct? Remember? Remember why we get this 0? So worry about your test, you done your test 3 times, so we move on. Okay, my question is, you understand why we have 0 here? Because this is 10, so we add 10 after the number, remember that? Okay, so now this one, 3 times 589. If you do the actual math, it will be hard for you. So you make this number easier, simpler. Okay, by what? Look at the number chart. It's a 500 and 589 somewhere right here. Somewhere right here. So 589 close to 500 or close to 600. 589 close to 500 or close to 600. 600. So instead of doing the actual number, we round it. We make this number simpler, we make it 600. So 5, 3 times 600, So we cover the 2 0 because it's 100, correct? So 3 times 6 is 18. So we write 18 and we add how many zero? 2 0. So that will be 1,800. That might be if you understand. Okay. So the same thing. Estimate 8 times 2,500. So 2,000 and 3,000. 2,500 right in the middle. So is that close? Remember 5 or more, you round up. Remember 5 or more, you round up. So you go close to 3,000, right? So instead of doing the actual number 2,500, you do 8 times 3,000. That's easier. So 8 times 3 is what?
What
about gas? 8 times 3 is
24.
24, and how many
zero?
3. 1, 2, 3, that will be 24,000, okay? So now I want you to do number 1.
And then salt started the motor.
5 times 30. So you round up or you round out 30? 33, when we're 33. So let me get the paper so we work together. Where's in my plastic one? Okay, so the actual number is 33,
yep.
Right?
All right.
So look up here. So we have 3 times. Is that 3? 5 times 33. Okay. So this number is kind of hard for you. So we need to estimate this number by rounding up or rounding down. So you round into the nearest 10. Look at 3 is 33, close to 30 or close to 40? 33 close to 30 or close to 40. So this is 30 and this is 40.
30.
And 33 will be here. So it's quite close to 30 or close to 40.
30.
So we make this number is 30. So we write 5 times, the new number is 30. Okay, so is that easier now? Is that easier? So now, this is multiples of 10. So we just cover the 0. 5 times 3 is?
15.
And we add 1 0 because of 10. So 5 times 33, kind of around 150, right? It's not actually exactly the answer, but it's about 150, correct? Okay, so I want you to write here on your paper, you will write 5 times 30.
I feel sick.
Equal 150. And do you understand why we have 30? Yes? Yes, okay. So the next one, number 2. Are you ready for number 2? Okay, who can do number 2? 7 times 48. What is your decision? What can we do to estimate?
7 times 48.
Okay, so 48. So we draw the number line. That's 40 and that's 50, right? 48 is somewhere here. So 48 close to 40 or close to 50?
50.
50. So my new problem will be 7 times 50. Okay. Now you do 7 times 5 is what?
7 times 5.
35. And then what do I do next?
Add
0. 1 0. Okay. So go ahead, do it.
So
we have 7 times 50 equal 350.
Why could Tony only see the
iron
sometimes?
Okay, so do number 2 on your own and give me your answer.
It's far away, but remember it's
2 times
175.
So I will show you this one. I will show you the number line for 175. So this is 100. And this is 200. So where is 165?
Up near 200.
Okay, so there you know the answer. Go ahead. 2 times 175. This number is hard, so you will. Okay, so 175 is close to 100 or is close to 200. Okay, so write a new sentence, 200. Now you get your answer. Two times two is what?
Four.
Four. And then what else?
Good. How much longer?
And then you add tomorrow.
20?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
What did salt tell
you? Okay, so six times 837.
That's not, that doesn't look like it's three, it looks like it's 18.
Which one?
No, it's
no, stay there.
400.
This is four.
Well, it looks like an H.
No, this is 4.
It looks like an H.
Oh, it looks like an H, but we are not talking about the letter. So put in the context that we are all writing about a number, right?
Well, it looks like it.
Yeah, it looks like it, but that's a 4. Okay, ready? 600 times 800, or 6 times 837. So close, can you tell me what you do with this?
So
I draw the number line, right?
Yes.
So this is 800, this is 900. 837 where?
800.
Close to what number?
Probably close to 800.
Yeah, so it's somewhere here, right? So it's close to 800, so my new sentence will be 6 times 800. Okay, Ava, give me your answer. 6 times 800. No, 6 times 800. So don't worry about the 20. 6 times
800.
Okay, look at the drum right there. Number 6 and count 8 times. Okay, so this one I write 48, and what else?
And
10. Don't forget the 20, right, Ava?
Yeah.
Okay, so I add 20 after the number. Now I get 4,800. Write down. So this one you will write 6 times 800 equal 4,800. Okay, so I give you some time for number 5. Go ahead to number 5, please. Go ahead to number 5. Number 5, 1,624. So I will help you with the number line, okay? So I have number line here. This is 1,000. This is 2,000. So 1,624 is near, it's close to 2,000. So your new, you know your new sentence will be 3 times 2,000 equals. Okay. Give me your answer, please.
Tony rubbed his eyes and sat up. Salt turned on a flashlight and handed him a compass. Salt pointed to a mark on the rim of it. Keep the front of the boat pointing at this mark. This will take us straight to Rose Island. So Tony took the wheel and steered the boat. Salt curled up in the back of the boat.
Okay, so give me the answer. If you're done, raise your hand.
Also was sleeping in the front of the boat. The air was
3 times 2,000. So again, we work on multiples of 1,000 already. So we make this one easier for you to do it.
What instructions did Salt give?
Okay, but give me the answer. Write the
answer.
You go west.
Yep, he said just follow the compass straight ahead.
Okay, so 3 times 5 is what? Remember, this is time. This is 3 times 2, I mean 3 times 2.
So 950.
6, so this will be 6. Now, Ava, I make sure you always pay attention to the sign. This is not addition. This is multiplication. Okay, do you get 6,000?
Yes.
Raise your hand. Okay, so in your paper, in your paper should be like this, 3 times 2,000 equals 6,000. Correct? Estimate each product, then tell if the estimate is greater than or less than the actual product. Okay, so 2 times 29. Give me your answer. 2 times 29.
Oh, 2 times 29.
So this is
closer to
30. 20 and 30. Stay close to what?
30.
Okay. So 2 times 30 equals. Go ahead, do it in your paper, please. Write it in your paper, please.
3 times 2 and 30.
We have 2 things to do for this one. The first thing, you estimate each product. Then you will tell if the answer, if the estimate is greater than or less than the actual number, okay? So first, I will write it. 2 times 30. Equal what?
60.
Do you think this one, this product, is greater than the actual one or less than?
Yes.
Look at the number you round up. Is that more than this one?
Yes.
That means it's greater, right? Because it's more. It's more than the actual numbers. Now, in another word, if you round up, the product will be greater than the actual. So you understand? If you round down, the product will be lesser. Okay? So this one, you will write this side, greater than. Do you understand why we have greater than? Because 30 is the estimate number is greater than 29. So it's certainly the product will be greater. Okay? Now number next, 4 times 41. So in 41,
huh? Seven.
Let's do 7. I'm sorry, I forget. So 7, 3 times 88. So I have number like here. First, this is 80, and this is 90. Where is 88? Is that close to 80 or close to 90?
90.
Close to 90. So then 88 somewhere here. Then my acceptance will be 4. Oh, wait. 3 times 90. Equal what? 3 times 90.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, raise your hand. You have your answer. One have answer. Everybody, did you get the answer? You either can do 3 times 9 or 9 times 3, right? You switch the number. Number like for what?
For that one.
3 times 9, you don't know the answer? Or what?
No, for...
Now let's finish this one.
Oh, we're doing that one.
Yeah.
Okay. No, we didn't
do that. Okay, so I count by 3. You should have your answer. 1, 2. Great, raise your hand. Ava, what do you have?
270.
Good, what do you have?
270.
270. Alice? What did you get though? So 3 times 9 is 27, right? Or 9 times 3 is 27. And then because you multiple of 10, you add 1 0 after that. Got it? Now this is the second thing. We just finished the first thing. Now the second thing is we need to tell if the estimate is greater than or less than the actual product. What do you think? Is 90 bigger than 88? Right?
Yes.
Is 90 bigger?
Mm-hmm.
So is that greater or lesser?
Greater.
Okay. So this one you write greater. Okay, let's do number 8. 4 times 41. So again, draw the number line so it will help you. I have 40 and 50. So 41 close to 40 or 50?
50.
41, where's 41 in the number line? 40. It's somewhere right 40. Here. So it's close to 40. So 40. Your 40. Sentence will be 4 times 40. 50. Equal. Okay, give me the answer. Are you guys here for me? Okay, go to computer because it's a little bit early. Oh, you guys don't have the library today. The computer. Where is Max?
He's at the library.
He has library? How come you guys not there? But the
library
The
librarian is out, so maybe she's just sending a couple kids to just to check out the book.
Okay.
I don't remember where it is, but the spells are green.
Okay, go Chi-Chi. Okay, do you have the answer for 1040? Ava?
Yes, 160.
Good, close.
160.
Alice?
60.
Okay, are we done yet? Are we still need to do something? Yeah, we done first part of the question. The second part is whether it is greater than or less than. What do you think? So this is 40. Is 40 less than 41?
No.
Is 40 less than 41?
Yes.
Yes, so the answer will be?
Less.
Less than. Okay. Numbers 11. 365. So I have 300 and 400 in my number chart. Where is 365? It's close to 300 or close to 400?
400.
So 365. Oh.
Oh my goodness.
I forgot. Okay, so 365 is somewhere here, okay? So I will make it like 400. Okay, so this is, where am I? Wait, am I on this one? 532. Okay, 532, so it will be 500 and 600. Let's do this one first. 532, where it is? Tell me, is that close to 500 or close to 600?
600.
532. Look at your number.
500.
Hmm? Well, so it's close, this is 532, right? So it's close to 500. So your new sentence will be 4 times 500. Give me the answer, please. Four times 500. 4 times 5 is 20. And you add 2012. That will be 2000. Now the next step is whether this estimate is greater than or less than. Who tell me? Less than or greater than?
It's recess time.
Okay, I need you to answer this my question first. This estimate is less than the actual or greater than?
Less
than. The reason is 500 is less than 532. So I want you to write this side less than. And then you each earn one star, then you can go. Leave your paper there because we continue it next week. So understand, everyone understand for this lesson? The first thing to do is you draw the number line so you can estimate it, okay?